closings with Payne and Dolan. We were up in Rapid River, Michigan, at an aggregate site with one of our portable asphalt plants, working on a county road project, County Road 513, which is located on the Stony Peninsula in Upper Michigan. The purpose of this project was part of a stimulus package through the Federal Forest Service. It was actually a county project being administered by the Michigan DOT. We were actually using several new emergent technologies on this project, which is considered a warm mix technology. Two of the products that we are actually using on this project as warm mix additives are being added to our hot mix asphalt mix, which is actually a 13A Marshall mix design as specified by Michigan DOT. One of the warm mix products that we are adding is actually a dry additive called Adbera. What Adbera is, a dry synthetic zeolite that actually helps foam the asphalt. Behind me, you can see a large boom in front of the bag hole. What that machine is actually a blower system where the Adbera is added into and then blown into the asphalt drum by a fiber port, which is located inside the asphalt drum. That material comes typically delivered in 3,000 pound tote bags, or can also be delivered by a bulk system and added into a silo and be added just like mineral filler is added at the asphalt plant. The second product that we are actually using is called Evotherm. Evotherm is actually a liquid that is added directly to the asphalt tank itself. Therefore, there is no extra equipment actually required to add the product. The material can either be added at an asphalt terminal, or in this case, on this project, we are adding it directly in our asphalt plant tank. What these are pictures of is actually the 3,000 pound totes of the Adbera product as it comes delivered. As you can see, the material actually comes in these totes and is actually hoisted up on these straps into our blower system. The application of this material is actually very easy. The blower system itself is not very complex. It actually just has a wave bottom and a blower on it. That's all this material is. County Road 513 in Rapid River. This is part of the 513 project where warm mix has been used. And you notice here, it's actually about a mile section of hot mix in the southbound lane and a mile section of warm mix in the northbound lane directly adjacent to one another. As you can see, there's actually no noticeable difference between the two in physical appearance. Approximately in the center of the problem. Right now the crew is actually paving with one of the warm mix products, which is Evotherm currently. Typical production temperatures at the plant have been, the hot mix asphalt has been about 305 to 310 degrees. Currently we are right now paving and producing at the plant at about 260 degrees. Behind the screen, the material is being laid down at approximately 255 to 250 degrees. Discernible difference between the hot mix and the warm mix visually, other than you really don't see any steam generally associated with the hot mix that they're paving at the 300 degree temperatures. The current section that they are paving right now consists of 4 inches of a full depth warm mix, which is 2 inches on the bottom and 2 inches on the top section of the Evotherm product. This current lane right next to us that I'm standing to is actually the hot mix product material. That lane on the other side is actually the warm-mix project. identical to the hot mix, except for the fact is we are paving at approximately 40 degrees cooler behind the street than we would with the hot mix, and we're achieving better than or equal density in all cases. Typically what we've seen on this project was almost a 1% increase in density, even though we are paving at those cooler temperatures. They're actually taking thermal imaging. Also, you can see on the back of the screen one noticeable difference that you may notice there. There's actually a thermal molding unit on the back of the screen that is measuring the entire temperature across the map to look for variations in temperature.